6:30. I was twirling my eyebrows and stuff, and I figured I would just cancel everything I was doing and just restart. Yeah. I'll have to work on my eyebrows a little bit clearer because I'm not all that happy with them at the moment. But I basically just put my concealer and primer and things. Everything like that. So now I'm gonna test this hack. Basically, you're supposed to be able to have like a really fluffy plush like sock. And you're supposed to be able to use the fluffy edge of the sock and rub your foundation onto your face with that part of the sock. And it's supposed to like really go on flawlessly. I have a blanket that's that plushy, but I'm not gonna use the blanket. I have a less plushy makeup remover towel. This is actually clean, it's just like stained from stuff before. And it's not as plushy, but I figure if it is plushy enough to take off makeup the way it's meant to, then maybe you can put on makeup. So I have my foundation here. And I'm gonna buff it on. Here, doesn't it look? And I don't really see anything wrong with the way that it just applied my foundation on my cheek, so I'm gonna keep it on. Maybe around 7:45, so I figured I would do this at an earlier time. Skip any comments to this. No. Anyway. I need like a lot of foundation. It's running down my head. Okay. It's like really liquidy. This kind I'm using is super duper liquidy, so be wary of that. If you use the Dream Wonder Touch Fluid, it's a super liquid. So please don't worry about me. I'm not saying my idea is 100% original here, but I am saying I think I found a new hack. I mean, yeah, I did kind of adapt off the idea of a girl using the sock as the way they on makeup, but you have like a makeup eraser, like the actual like a makeup eraser thing. You can use that to put on your foundation. That all you have to do is rub in circular motions, and it looks just fine. Or if you have these that I got a warmer, you literally can wet it and take off your makeup, or you can use a dry and just buff your makeup on. Like, come on, it's, you gotta admit that's kind of genius. It's like, I'm gonna take it off all with one freaking cloth. That's amazing. So, I'm just putting a little extra on already on my skin. That way I can just put it on. I'm gonna be working 8 hours, so I want to make sure like the makeup is really gonna be on. And this is like a good size, so you can just take it, pull it up or whatever. Because she basically wanted you to hold the sock kind of like this. So for this, you can like use it like a flat top kabuki brush, something like that. And just blend it. Yeah, just like I put it near my chest, out to balance it. And be like, does my makeup look good? Because I blended it with a cloth. I think it has a good finish. I'm just gonna go in and use a little bit on my fingers. And take care of the hyperpigmentation. Break out marks here. Otherwise, I'm pretty much good. Pretty pissed. I like the way that it went on my face, and I don't really see anything wrong with it. Now I'm just gonna put some on my neck because I wanna make sure I'm not like wearing a mask. I do this with every foundation and all the foundations I ever wear. I put them on my neck because pretty much almost all my foundations are a little bit darker than me, but I think this one's probably one of the closest matches I have. So, to make sure I am task for the final dose, that is blended. I this to be a nice natural makeup look. Appropriate for school, appropriate for work, appropriate for like everything. And I was left the time. It's powder is the messiest part. But I used two different kinds. If I knew what one of them was, I will show you. I knew I was like too organized for what I needed because the one thing I needed to have by myself. I find what I really need. Here's another bit. Okay, sorry it took like forever there. Never knew it would be under my bed. Okay, so. This powder gives me more coverage. And I have literally like two other ones. This is the one that has the most paint. So basically, I just put some on top of what I have on my hand. So give me more coverage. And I know it's not going to break me out because it's positions for you. And their stuff usually is like tough free, paraben free, and a whole bunch of other things that are more natural on this. This is pretty much my touch up powder. I do use a transition one. A translucent powder. Use that to kind of bake with. And I just use it all over. My face is gonna look all matte now, but I bring it back to life with some highlight earlier. Skin is here. I'll put my powders here. Big splash here. Now I'm gonna put this on my blue brush. Put on my ears so they match with everything. And then I put it on. The moment of truth, which is setting matter. That's literally everything. I'll use one of my brushes to brush away. So I use this to like pack it. $6.47. Holy shit. I didn't even eat it. My face to me is my priority because this is how I'm gonna look. But yeah, I mean, like, eating is important too. I want to do this first. I see, like, a white line. You guys won't be able to tell. But putting some foundation closer to my mouth. My mom is like my blending buddy. She's like, oh, we didn't blend enough. But I highly doubt my dad would know who he's talking about, so I have to make sure I'm like really blended here. I'd be surprised my dad was like, you didn't even fix your makeup. No, highly put. If you don't know what baking is, I'm pretty sure I already explained it in other videos. But baking is pretty much the body temperature. The body temperature heats up the powder, so it makes a highlight, basically. To me, it's like a stain, almost. And it just makes your makeup look more flawless, and smoother and better, and everybody loves it. It's basically the big trend, even though drag queens have been doing this for like a long last time. But it's like we're just catching on to things, so of course everyone's like fascinated with it. But for me, I'm doing it in the purpose of me remaining pale, because my foundations end up being dark since. It's hard for someone as pale as me nowadays to have a drugstore foundation. So I kinda custom blend my own. And I use this powder as if it's everything to me, pretty much. Because it kinda is. If you get it on you, it'll just brush off anyway, so no big deal. I know I look fucking crazy, but bear with me. this is actually the perfect time to do your eyeshadow, because if you get any of the eyeshadow dusting off, your outer underneath your eyes will catch it, which is why a lot of people usually will do their eye makeup first. But not in my world. I do everything wrong. So, I have like all these palettes. I have this one in the night, but I'm not going to use that because I'm in the day. I have the Paris. It has a whole bunch of natural shades. It's actually one of my ears. I have my mild. This one I used to take around with me all the time if I want a dark eyeshadow. I have e.l.f. Eye Enhancing Palette. This is actually made for brown eyes. So maybe I'll go for this because I'm feeling a little smoky palette. Perfect if you want to smoke, yeah, but I'm not really going for that. Fake eyeshadow palette from e.l.f. I might use that for some facial highlighting, maybe. This has shades for your face here, and then shades for your eyes, which I never really used. And I'm gonna go with Eye Enhancing Palette. There's no names of the colors or anything. The name of the palette is just as brown as that love has specific brown. I'm gonna get this really white, kind of vanilla color right in there. I'm just gonna flip it on my eyes as like a skin tone kind of shade. It's just like my eyeballs are perfect. I don't have any red veins or anything. I like to use a white or like a skin tone kind of shade for that. Maybe look like you have perfect eyelids. Maybe don't. Plus it just makes you look more like I know I look like hot mess now, but trust me, everything will come together. I don't want to do anything too risky and too daring, because I'm just doing this for like a few day job, but I'm not trying to be like, it's Jessica Rabbit. I'm just probably going to use one of these somewhat glittery shades. It's like a glittery, sultry kind of brown. This is why I said it's good to lay a powder under your eyes. catches the marshmallow. And then when you brush it away, it's like nothing even happened. And then I'm going to put this rusty kind of color. Just in the middle of the eyelid, so it kind of brings attention to your eyes a little bit. I feel like I'm definitely putting more effort into my makeup today, and I haven't done that in a long time. Like, I'm more like pretty chill with my makeup. I don't do much makeup like I used to, but today I feel like I'm definitely trying more. Which is a good thing because I want to impress. I mean, it's still like family, like, you see, on the holidays and stuff, but it's still at the same time. I don't know. Tell me how you guys think about that kind of thing. Like, to me, it's like, I fuck up, like, I'm really gonna fuck up, because it's like, they're family, so if I mess up in some way, they can still remember and be like, oh yeah, we can't have Emily here at this job, because she doesn't know what she's doing, like, I don't know. I get these weird thoughts. It's like, I mean, yeah, I'm kind of overthinking things because it's only gonna be 3 days unless they really need me after and then they hire me, but I wouldn't expect that. Because it's like shit. I don't want them to, like, look down on me. I mean, I only know that I was gonna answer first. That's the only thing I know that I'm supposed to apparently do. Like, I don't know what else they're gonna try to make me do. They all know I'm, like, tiny and petite, so I don't think they would really try to, like, push too much on me to do. But I can't be certain. I don't know. I was gonna do next time. I'm trying to think what my eyeliner is. Sure, I have the other bit. Here it is. There's a little makeup box right here. Now this part's pretty important. Sure, my wing is gonna be all thick and stuff. Like, not too extreme. 7 o'clock. I don't know, we leave at 7:45. Of course, I wanna be ready before that. And this is a $1 eyeliner, by the way. It works really good. The only thing I don't like about this eyeliner is somehow transfers down to your lower lid, and I have no idea how it does that, but it's annoying as hell when it happens. It's like I wanted it to be here, not down here. And I got this out of Clarence. TJ Maxx. It's where I've been getting the W7 things. I want to go back and get more like facial eyeshadow stuff too of this brand. I actually have like a pigment that I use as my highlight, but I'm gonna try this skin tone whitish shade right here. Smells kind of strong, like sweet, like floral-y, perfumey. That's really nice. I'm kind of lucky that I have like these eye cheekbones, so like I think in a way I can kind of get away with using a little bit more because I'm so thin and because my cheekbones are like higher. I've seen people like they only put the stuff like right here. I like do it like all over my cheeks, so I'm just weird. I'm gonna use this silver kind of color to highlight his, like I said, impale his Casper, and I feel like silver highlights look prettier on this impale skin. bunch of glitter. Kind of pulling in like a weird direction, but I don't think so. Keeps it. So keeps it. So I have some Q-tips. My nerves kind of went away, but I noticed that probably have that feeling again. I just like when I'm in the car and we're like waving, I'll be like shit. This is gonna look kind of gross in me, like, oh. It's just me doing this for myself, so. If you were to like have a client or something, I wouldn't be able to do this. Kind of pull the wing upwards. I'll have to go in and fix that little thing there. Some eyeliner's missing. This really helps if you like pull it up and take the extra bits of it away. And that's what I bought, like, a whole bunch of Q-tips of me, because they were really mistake. I'm accident prone, not in, like, the physical way. Knock on wood. But accident prone the makeup way, for sure. Like, I'm always having some kind of mess up with my makeup. But it's okay. Which is why you guys have been here for like almost an hour. Oh my god, sorry. But you can look at it as like a raw uncut. Are you guys making it? I'm kind of scared that today's gonna like start to be a bad day because of my making mishaps and stuff, but you know, like maybe. I love how this is like a off brand, like knockoff of the Baby Lips. Like you can tell by the packaging, they tried to do Baby Lips. But I got it from Dollar Tree. But the cool thing about it is that it's actually really, really moisturizing. It actually works just as good, maybe even better than Baby Lips. It's just the packaging is so cheap since it's a dollar, but that's the first time it actually ever, like, split on me, the bottom of it, but whatever. I'm gonna bring this little eyeshadow in with me just in case I, like, want to touch up later if I'm able to. Not that I'm actually like expecting to like go to the bathroom and like touch up, just in case. So that's how it happens. Somehow some of the eyeliner gets stuck like right up here. So then when I blink, it goes down here. And I'm like, I don't want you to do that though. I'm gonna bring up my eye. I'm gonna use some white eyeshadow. It's a tip in helping me with my look. Because I don't know if I mentioned, but I got absolutely zero sleep, not even exaggerating. So I need all the help I can get by looking weak. Instant brightness. Before and after. Well, before or after it's switched up in my camera. The left is right and the right is left. So really, when I'm putting eyeshadow on this eye, I'm really putting it on this eye right now. What else can I do? I could try to get my eyebrows a second time. I just really don't want them to be too like anything. First time, what is it? Maybe. But I'm like trying to do this ever so slightly. Ah, shit. I just thought about it. They're probably not gonna want me to have some kind of hat on, is what I would imagine. So I have to make sure my hair is a little bit too long. my porch. Okay, not gonna mess up them anywhere, or I'll go like this here. This is like the third time I'm using this. I need to fix something. Waterproof mascara, of course, because you're gonna be crying and shit. Shit. You see the little speck? Right above my freaking eyelashes? Yeah. That was the mascara wand. I learned a hack though. They say if you like wait for the mascara to dry, you can just scrape it off. Hopefully that's true. This is a really dry and brittle mascara. That's the con about it, but it does work fine. And the brush is definitely not the most gentle, but gets the job done. My eyelashes look so fucking long though, yo. Like, it looks like I freaking have glasses on. So I'm pretty much done with like everything makeup wise, really. It's just down to setting powder and letting down my hair and brushing my teeth and eating. So I can't really complain. I think I might use these Bonnie Bella lip glosses. Give myself a new sparkly look. Pitch him up? Pitch him up? He's a me. I'm not dirty. Can I say hi? I'm not. Hey! How are you? Oh, she's my friend. Yeah, hey, baby. Oh, hello. You getting ready with me? Yeah. Oh, he's so cute. He's probably like, I know she's going somewhere. I know I'm not going to see her. What's going on? You're gonna see me when Dad comes home. Let's see if this is true about the freaking mascara things not coming off until. Oh, yep. See? They're gone. They're on my future. Sweet. Don't have to stress about these anymore. This will take 10 pop time. So the god are believing. That's the thing, seems to be. This just gives me a little something something like that. I mean, I've yet to brush my teeth and stuff. This is just how you get like an idea of what moving on my lips. And these are like razor things I use for my teeth. I got them at 5 from the Oh, are you smell good things, little lip gloss? Is that what you smell? He had his nose up in the air. Is that what you smell? Oh, yeah. Is this now scrumptious, Papa? He's a honey. He's a cute one. Okay. You're distracting me, Mr. No, it's okay. You don't have to eat. He was like, oh my gosh. Life decisions, Griffin. Life decisions. Now I'm just pulling this frosting one. Same brand. Still long enough. Like peppermint. So you guys just went and watched all of my makeup application if you really didn't watch everything. And I appreciate it too. And I like too much makeup. But I'll never be the one thing really. Even if it's cheap makeup, I guess I'll love it. Makeup and I ran out of my Wet n Wild spray that I use, so I'm down to this much of my Elf mist. I even spray my ears too, just because it's said everything. It's okay. Oh, you want to say hi? He's so cute. I love him. This I got at a TJ Maxx also. I think I should. Okay. I thought my laptop died or something even though it was plugged in. It didn't make sense. So, this is what my hair is looking like. You need to make sure it looks acceptable. Good to me because I don't know if they would be chill enough to let me wear a hat back there or not. I'll probably just bring a little beanie in case and take it off when I enter the door. I mean, it's not like anyone's really gonna see me, so it's like I don't know if they really care if I wore a hat. But for the sake of being professional, I probably wouldn't. But then again, it's a family business. And from what I know of, really just doing calls, so I don't know what to expect. And showered last night, so that I would be all fresh for today. I'm not sure how this is gonna go. We leave real soon, 7:15. Yep. So I just gotta munch on something quick. And I gotta close my rooms when I empty it and sign off everything. Yeah, wish you. See you guys later.